Welcome once again to the Center for Computer Art and Innovation. I have Alex McLeod. Alex is in the exhibition that's in the University Gallery right now called Real Fake. And you'll see his work on the console there as the written description is.
I first found out about Alex's work
when we were putting together the Real Fake. And Claudia Hart was the one that said, "What do you think of this guy? My students showed him to us." And I went to his website and I was immediately captivated. I thought it was absolutely awesome stuff. And if anybody remembers from the cinema class that we were in, I was like, "God, check this guy out, guys. Look at this, look at that." We were lucky to have him here. And it turned out, when I first invited him, I wasn't 100% sure what software he used, what kit, what nothing, so on and so forth. Turns out, he's a cinema head, okay? And we've been Dits and Meyer all day long. And yet, from the twilight of devastation, shown in these strange dioramas, lies possibilities for hope and rebirth in our digital milieu. Through the artist's new approaches to concepts as varied as ecological responsibility and the shared intersections between photography and painting. Please welcome.
Oh yeah, so this is the kind of work that I do. It's all constructed digitally in 3D. I started in drawing and painting, and then that's what I graduated from at University of Toronto. And I used digital software like Photoshop and Illustrator to construct my paintings before I made them. So I would try to do some 3D and try to do some vector stuff and put it all together and then print it and then try to make paintings from that. A friend of mine who was also graduating from my year, was a curator at one of the galleries, was like, "Oh, this is great, how big is this? Like, can I put this in a show?" And I said, "It's not big." So it was cool because she was still open to that. She's like, "Yeah, it's new, just it's hard." And then from there I kept going. And this was at a point where I knew almost nothing in cinema. I can make mountains, preset mountains. I made a cloud, and that's what I use now. It's like my staple. Just out of spheres, because I didn't know. I was like, "Yeah, I'll make a cloud." I like that, the aesthetic of like that post graffiti kind of drip vector thing. It's really kind of so I made that design sphere. It was like super simple. Mountains, and then I think that was it. I think I put strings on the clouds, and that was it. About as far as I went. And then from there, it's just like, "Oh, okay, well, maybe I'll figure out how to illustrate on murals that are like 40 feet long, but it's like that adhesive vinyl that gets destroyed." And yeah, but for our prints, I'll do two editions and then a light box print. This is another one from the same show. I don't use lights in my scene. I use meshes, and then I give them materials that emit light. And that way, I've got like these things, like these snake things. It could be some kind of rope light or neon tubes, or something that looks kind of odd, but it looks somewhat familiar. I think that's important to make a sense of believability, or even to make the person question if they're looking at something real. The only thing really real is the wood grain textures. So they're all taken from photographs and maps. This was one that I made for the same show, and I was really excited about it because a new version of Cinema came out for V-Ray, and I was able to put in so many trees. Like it was this roundabout way of rendering, so full amount of render time, so I could have like 20,000 trees in a forest, and the computer wouldn't get bogged down. So I was going to town with all these trees, and I was like, "Yeah." Kind of goes back to one of those earlier photographs of that building in Russia, sort of in the woods alone. It's got no like time or space. And that's what the work really is about. It's sort of about the interpenetration of time and space, but also the connectivity of life and death, rebirth. So, which is a universal idea. It's another one too. There's some gold and some bling. It's like the most bling one that I made. And I was really like nervous about adding gold materials into my scenes. I felt like so seductive and people would think, "Oh, this is pretty looking." And then I started to play with like the illusion of like depth, but also like of the mesh. So this is just a wireframe, but it's like it could be contemporary architecture, but it could be the 3D digital version of it.